Let's say for whatever reason you got stomach acid on your hand. Well, stomach acid has a pH of 1.5 to 3.5. So in about 5 minutes, you're gonna see mild redness and tingling on your skin. Within 30 minutes, you'll see a burning sensation, maybe swelling. Prolonged exposure more than that, and the acid will start breaking down your skin's protective barrier. Basically, we're talking a chemical burn with peeling and blistering. If you swallow a piece of gum, some people think it's gonna get stuck in your digestive tract. Actually, that's not completely true. The thing is, gum is commonly made from a substance called butyl rubber. It's the same thing that you see in glue, sealant, saran wrap, your car tires even. So when that gum lands in your stomach, your saliva enzymes and your stomach acid can't break it down. So what happens is the muscles in your digestive tract just move the gum along, and eventually your body flushes it out naturally in about a day or two. When your gallbladder makes a gallstone, it looks like a tooth. How it forms is your liver produces bile. It's this yellow-green liquid that your gallbladder then stores. And when you eat fatty foods, your gallbladder releases bile into your small intestine, and bile breaks down the fat. The problem is, if that recipe goes wrong, let's say there's an imbalance of ingredients, well then the bile starts to crystallize, and that's how gallstones are formed. They can be the size of a grain of sand up to the size of a golf ball. If you get recurring gallstones, and if your doctor removes your gallbladder, well then, your body no longer has a storage system to store and release bile in controlled amounts whenever you eat fatty foods. So instead, bile flows directly from the liver into your small intestine. We're talking about small, continuous flow or trickle, even when you're not eating. So your body can still digest fats, but it may be less efficient during super fatty meals, since you can't get that blast of concentrated bile when your body needs it. Most people don't know that your pancreas can eat itself. So the pancreas' job is to produce digestive enzymes, right? And normally, those enzymes remain inactive until they reach the small intestine. And when they activate, that's how they break down food. But in some people, these enzymes activate prematurely inside their pancreas. So then they start breaking down the pancreatic tissue, and you get inflammation and damage, otherwise known as acute pancreatitis. If you get stomach cancer, a common cause could be H. pylori. It's a bacteria you can get from contaminated food, and then it squats in your stomach uninvited. But there's a reason why the stomach acid can't kill it. The thing is, your stomach acid can be neutralized by alkaline. But what H. pylori does is, it makes an enzyme. And this enzyme breaks down the urea in your stomach, and it turns it into an ammonia cloud shield that surrounds the bacteria. And that's how the bacteria protects itself from your stomach acid. But then, it buries itself inside your stomach mucus layer, and it releases these toxins to destroy the mucus barrier. Basically, it's eating the nutrients from your damaged stomach cells. The most expensive medicine costs $3.5 million. It's called Hemgenics, and it's used to treat hemophilia B, which is a very rare genetic bleeding disorder. People with this disorder don't have enough of a clotting protein called factor 9, so even minor cuts can become life-threatening if that bleeding doesn't stop. But this medicine uses a harmless virus to deliver a functional gene into the patient's liver cells. But the reason why it's so expensive is because it's a one-time intravenous therapy. But also, gene therapy typically takes decades of research. Yet there's an ultra-small population of people with this disorder, so not enough to share the R&D costs. The thing is, despite the high price tag, the treatment isn't guaranteed. Subscribe.